Hey, this is Mirza from Siamese, and you're listening to Total Rock right now.
Hey, this is Andreas from Siamese. You're listening to Total Rock.
Welcome back, or of Total Rock. And today I'm very excited. I got two members of this band and I'm really excited about their release. I got Mirza and Andreas of Siamese all the way from Denmark. They got a great album coming out tomorrow, 10th of December. It's called The Home. We've been blasting some of their singles over the last couple of months already because the album just got pushed and pushed. They were teasing us, but now it's finally here. Thank you very much for joining me, Mirza and Andreas. How are you doing?
Thank you. Good.
Yeah, I'm good too, man. It's great. And I'm sorry about us pushing that album. I'm sorry to everyone.
I'm guessing it's not completely your fault. I'm guessing our neighbor Corona had some stuff to do with that. But
no,
finally,
it's Adele's fault. It's Adele's fault.
Adele.
Yeah, because she pressed so many vinyls that the production time was 7 months. So we were trying to press a vinyl in August, and we were like, no, it can be done in December. And we were like, oh shit, okay, fuck. So that's the reason, actually, simply because we had to have the product, and the product was just being pushed because of Adele and Corona, I guess.
Well, luckily, no one can be upset at Adele for too long. So we get the album and we're still friends with Adele. But I want to touch on some of the topics from the album. As I said, I've been enjoying the tracks for the last couple of months already. I had to listen to the album. So now I have the complete experience in my head and I cannot wait for the rest of the world to enjoy it with us. But I want to touch on the name of the album. It's called Home. And if I got it right, also through the artwork of the album, it touches on Copenhagen as home. Okay, if I'm mistaken, the artwork also has the coat of arms of Copenhagen. But in a previous press release that was sent to us, you referred to Copenhagen as not the lover, not as home, but as a mistress. So what is going on between you guys in Copenhagen? Is there some sort of a love-hate relationship? Is there a forbidden love? What's going on in Denmark?
I think what you're referring to is probably my kind of development with my own hometown, with it first being this dangerous kind of thing that gets you lured into all kinds of trouble. Like, that was my previous kind of perception of Copenhagen, that this is where I could party, this is where I could get lost in everything, and I could lose myself, and you know, there was a lot of things. And now, since Corona, I think Copenhagen has become more of a home, of a real home to me. And I think that's where we are now. Talking about the album cover, Andreas can fill you in, because it was initially his idea, actually.
Well, it all started with the song Home. And we felt like that song kind of started the whole new sound. And we just kind of felt more and more of the songs kind of felt like it was about our home in some way. And just brainstormed about, you know, what's an iconic, simple image that we can put on the album if we call it Home. And I just sent a couple of pictures, like of keyholes, to Mirza, and we picked one together and send it to this guy who did some, he could do some graphics and I think take some photographs. And he actually came up with, he went to like one of the bridges here in Copenhagen, just took a picture of the crest of Copenhagen. And that was such a cool, simple idea to incorporate that like in the artwork with a keyhole. That was basically the cover.
And it's not completely about Copenhagen, if I got it right. There are some kind of breakup love stories as well. So I thought, does it mean that the partner is also part of the story of home, of leaving home, of not feeling at home? So if I'm wrapping up my brainstorming through the word home and relationship, so is a relationship a home, or what is your definition of home? What makes a home a home?
No, I think what we wanted to do with all of the songs is encapsulate or do something that happens in these four walls. home. So why we called it home was also because all the stories that are not, you know, related to Copenhagen or something like that, they were stories that happened to us, like in real life. So that's why we said, like, okay, we need to get all these stories. They happened in between within our four walls because we were confined within these four walls. So that's like the concept of the whole songwriting. As even though it's a relationship thing, then this relationship was going on in these four walls. We couldn't move anywhere because Corona didn't allow it. So everything, every story, kind of what's going on here is something that's related to home.
Further, yeah, it was also like all the songs were actually written at like in Denmark in our home because it was during lockdown. Most of the writing. Sorry, Mirza. Go on.
Yeah, not a problem. And also we wanted to kind of we realized some stuff about being this much home. About we kind of opened ourselves up to the relationships we had with other people, like our friends, our family, and we came really, 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 really close with everyone and everything we had in our own proximity. We were used to traveling, at least, you know, and Andreas would be in Stockholm, he would be in London, I would tour, you know. We kind of started the appreciation of our own home, and that is basically why we wanted to call it home, to remind us of a very special and difficult time, but also a very beautiful time.
Would you say that a person is also part of the definition of a home, or maybe even a person leaving and that place is not home anymore? Would you relate to that?
Sure. Sure, but I don't think that's the way we thought about it. We didn't pin home onto a person. We pinned home onto a whole different bunch of situations and life changing situations, if you might say so. And it was all going on, and even all it was happening within the barriers of our home. So it's not pinned on someone particular. It's just us living our life in our home and what it meant at this point, because it was a special time. Any other time, it would have been pretty fucking boring to say, we just wrote about what happened in our home life. But right now, 2020 and 21, that was pretty fucking special because you've never experienced something like this period we just went through. And that's what makes it interesting, in my opinion.
Mm. Andreas, do you have a more romantic answer to the definition of the word home?
Well, I think that the song, to be specific, about the song Home, that's basically just a love song to Copenhagen. And we actually like very literally sing that wherever I go around, like we just, well, my experience, like the more I travel, the more I like Copenhagen. For some reason, you feel like a deeper connection with where you come from. I do, at least. But all the songs are basically like about stuff we experience. But yeah, in some ways, as Mirza said, it's just basically stuff we've experienced in lockdown, or conversations or thoughts we've had during this time where we actually had time to think about that kind of stuff that you maybe wouldn't be able to or wouldn't take the time to if it was like business as usual, you know?
Exactly.
So this next question came up in so many interviews I had over the last couple of months, and it came up in so many personal conversations I had as well. So I feel like a lot of people changed their state of mind, their way of seeing the world change over the last 2 years. And it kind of touches on one of the songs on the album as well. And people became either more political or more numb. And to add to that, either more hopeful about the future of society in general or about their personal future, or less hopeful. But then as I was writing that question to confront you with that, I was exposed to an old song that you wrote, Holy Alliance of United Tyrants, from 2012, that was about the Arab Spring, about the world going into a better situation because of the activism that was rising. So again, with that in mind, of you kind of in the past, almost 10 years ago, being really political, writing about it, do you feel like you've changed, became more political, more hopeful, less political, more feeling or kind of shut yourself in with your feelings after everything that happened in the world and in Denmark over the last 2 years?
I think first and foremost, and that goes for 2012 as well, I am more of an individual than I'm a politician or saying something political. So when we wrote NUM, it was just a question of us doing kind of a status about how the hell we're feeling right now. And it's scary that we're feeling like now. And that's not to say it in a leftist way or a rightist way or whatever politics you want to put down on that. I'm not bashing anyone. I'm just saying that I, as a human, all of a sudden felt kind of indifferent. And I think because me and Andreas talked about this and he said he felt the same. So for me, I'm not trying to be political. I'm not trying to, I'm just taking myself as an instrument and telling the world, well, this is how I feel. Do you feel the same? Are we on, you know, are we going somewhere? And it can go both ways or it can just stay in the middle. But I think it's very important that I use myself as the center of it. And then I tell a story and hopefully that will resonate. And when we do the lyrics, I talk to Andreas a lot of times. So what do you think about this topic? And he'll be, yeah, definitely. Or sometimes he'll be, I don't think that's a good topic. So to answer your question, is the world going a better place? Is the world going a worse place? Definitely the world is going a better place. Anybody who tells you that otherwise, they don't have the full picture. Some people still believe that like countries like Africa and stuff like that, that it's like way back in the 60s. That's not the point here. Things are getting better. We're just in a really, really shit situation right now. And every news you get is bad. So I understand why people would be demoralized. But saying that the world has gone to shit, that's simply not true.
And I think it's important to just want to elaborate that what Mirza said, especially the old song, Holy Alliance. I can't even say the name, the title is so many years ago, but NUM is yeah, it's very much looking inwards and trying to stay on our own court, I guess you say, not being too preachy. I don't think we're in a big hurry to be like political or anything. It's about, yeah, being bombarded with, you know, basically everything that's going on in the world all the time. And it's kind of like catching yourself, not being affected by it as much as you would like yourself to be. And that kind of, wow, you stop recognizing yourself, or you feel guilty, basically, not being more shocked about everything, basically. But yeah, I totally agree with Mirza on the whole world situation.
Well, I'm going to try and keep it positive, but I want to touch on something really personal, especially to you, Mirza. The closing track of the album, am I saying correctly? Sloboda?
Sloboda.
Sloboda, which, if I'm not mistaken, means freedom in Serbian.
Yeah.
So if I got it right, you grew up in a refugee camp and then moved to Copenhagen. So that story is about finding a new home, about fighting for your freedom. And it's sad and funny at the same time that over the last 2 years, people have been fighting for their freedoms, but a very different type of freedom. So coming from that story of refugees that obviously rose up over the last couple of years to even more headlines, but people are seeing it a different way. How do you feel coming from that story and seeing how the narrative is completely different and not welcome these days? And Andreas, how do you feel being next to Mirza, also seeing the news and not understanding or understanding where the story is going today?
For me, I wrote that song just as much as a reminder to myself. In this climate of not falling short of the idea that we need to keep people out. So that's the first thing I'd like to say. It's just as much telling myself that, hey, you also came from this, because I understand what you're saying, because right now we're doing all we can to keep refugees out. Like, we can't afford it, we can't do this and we can't do that. I don't find that to be necessarily completely true. I don't know it. I'm not a politician, but it's a reminder to myself to keep an open heart. That's the first thing of it. The other thing is that I maybe, you know, how am I going to say this without sounding cocky? I made it. I kind of, through everything I've been through, I wasn't allowed to visit my girlfriend when I was younger because I was not Danish. I wasn't, but I was still the captain of the football team, but I wasn't, you know, there were so many things that were like this, so crazy and so weird to me. But I wanted to write that song to like, be like, even though I had all these things against me where I could have, if I didn't have the confidence, I could have just settled. I could have just said, well, I'm never going to be good enough for this because I couldn't, obviously people will reject you through your life. Whatever reason, it might not be just racially motivated, but there will be rejections. Knowing that I had that against me as well, this was kind of the song where I would say, no, even though you put that on me, it's the fact that you gave me the freedom that made me make it, you know. It was just like, I just wanted to do something where I was like, okay, so I had these bad times and I didn't even think about them as bad times. It was just later on me and as a grown up reflecting and being like, whoa, that's really crazy that I went through that. And I didn't even flinch an eye. I was just like, okay, I just got to keep going. And I did, and I'm here. And, you know, and I think for me, that's why that song is important, because I'm proving a point, and I'm proving a point hopefully for some people, other people too, because I believe some other people that weren't me might have stopped. I know I have a couple of friends that I grew up with and they just gave up because there was like, the notion was like, they don't like us anyway. So why bother trying? And yeah, so we, you know, some brilliant people. I've played with some footballers like in our club. Those guys were the best guys in the team, but they didn't get a shot because they didn't have the support at home and they didn't have the support at the club. So a lot of things going on. And yeah, basically I think that's what I wanted to say.
Andreas?
I totally forgot the question already. You have
to... Sorry, it was a long speech.
No, but it's kind of weird for me talking about the song. I'm very much invested in the lyrics and all that stuff, and I'm very proud of Mirza as a friend. He's probably one of the best like integration cases in Denmark, I would say. But but it's definitely true. You just wanted a fucking award for like how would you describe it? It's just like
just for working hard, I guess.
Rock community in Denmark.
Yeah.
But it's just really, that's really cool to me for like as a friend to witness that. But I feel weird talking about the subject because I've never tried anything remotely like close to that. So I don't think it's I'm not in a position to talk about that subject. I think
he's so very respectful, this friend.
Oh, but maybe I should shut the fuck up on this one. That's how I feel. I feel totally fine about that. I can talk a lot about
that. I think that's song, also an answer.
Like it's not something that happened in my life, but I've been very close to this guy who is his story. So, you know.
Well, Andreas, I actually really like your comment, which saying, I prefer not to make a comment because it's not my place, which should be an answer to so many other questions that I think a lot of us are being asked on a day-to-day basis, accepting the fact that we don't know enough. So you kind of apologize for that, I totally respect that. I think it's also an answer to many other situations that we need to realize that could be an answer.
I just want to add that you can, of course, educate yourself in certain matters that it's like a big deal in your life or whatever, but I don't want to have an opinion just to have an opinion. I think it's a very modern thing right now that as soon, maybe I could have an opinion about this. I have to tweet about this. I'm not in a hurry to have a lot of opinions. It's just, I don't really know enough about it, as you said yourself, about a certain subject in Sloboda. So, yeah.
Well, I appreciate both of your answers to that question. So thank you very much for opening up and sharing about that. I want to wrap up with two rumors that I found online. One of them we're probably going to know more in just a couple of hours when the album drops, but maybe we're going to know more with the extended edition, the deluxe edition, or maybe future releases. So I know that you guys are influenced by many genres of music. You've done some covers in the past. Some of your fans online think that there's a Can You Feel the Love Tonight from The Lion King cover as a hidden track. Is that true?
What?
Is that coming out with Home, or maybe the deluxe edition, or maybe something that you're only going to do on a stage? Can we see a Lion King cover?
You're lying to us. You're taking the piss out of us. No way. Somebody really said that?
Yeah, I found some rumors online. I cannot reveal my sources, but I need your answer. Is that true or false?
Very funny. Very funny. Yeah. I am surprised. That was very funny. That was actually, but there is a cover on the album.
That's probably one of our friends who said that just to take a piss.
There is a cover on the album though.
Which one is that?
It's called Yoga. That's a Björk cover.
Oh. I remember seeing that.
We're not doing Elton John or Simba covers.
but I have some extra info on that, especially that song. I was once a participant in a talent show called Idols, Pop Idol. I came in second, and the first song I sang was Can You Feel the Love Tonight?
Nice.
There you go. Full circle.
Maybe that's where it came from.
Now we basically have to do the cover.
It has to be. Okay, you heard it first. Okay, and the second rumor that I'm guessing started after your recent tour in the UK about your pre-show warm-up routine. Is it true that you're blasting Roxette, Listen to Your Heart, in the dressing room and only then going on stage?
Yes.
Is that true?
That one is true.
Okay. I'm glad we're sharing all the juicy details right here on Total Rock. So thank you very much for sharing that with me. Mirza and Andreas, before we say goodbye, and we said that the album is coming out tomorrow, Home, everybody needs to check it out. It's going to be amazing in your ears. Is there anything else you want to add to fans and listeners out there?
Thank you for listening. And for God's sake, take care of each other. Get the vaccine if you have the time and the possibility, and we'll see you out there in 2022.
Hell yeah.
Guys, thank you very much for your time. Really excited and really hoping for news about you visiting our town so we can mosh and enjoy the party sounds of Sammy's and Home. That's out tomorrow, so make sure to check it out. Thank you very much, guys.
Thank you. Bye.